You are watching NBS Always. Welcome to People and Power. My name is Mable Twegumye Zake. As I speak right now, we've just arrived at the residence of Professor Ezra Suruma here in Bunga. Now, in this episode, we'll look at his personality, the power behind him, and how he has been able to influence decisions that have impacted on society in one way or another. Now, during the time when he was finance minister, he was awarded for his outstanding service as best African minister in 2008, and of course he's served government in different positions altogether. He's still currently senior presidential advisor, and also he's just received the appointment of Chancellor Makerere University. Join me as we go to meet the one and only Professor Ezra Suruma. So what time do you usually go to work?
It depends.
Can I enjoy my coffee? Yes, you can enjoy your coffee. All right. Hoping we are not making you late for work.
Having been a minister and an advisor and so on, my time is not strictly structured. I can be as early as 7:30 or 8, as late as 10, 11 or midday. And my return might be as late as midnight. It's not uncommon to find me in the office.
Well, a very good morning. We're finding you on your way to work.
Yes, thank you. It's good to see you.
Good to see you too. Congratulations upon you. The appointment as Makerere University Chancellor.
Thank you very much.
Well, were you ready for this particular appointment or position?
I think so. It's a ceremonial position. They call me titular head of Makerere University. And I'm of course pleased to be awarded the privilege. And I hope that in some way I can bring some grace and truth to the position.
Did you see this coming? Were you even surprised when bit?
Well, it was in the papers for a few months before it actually came. So I can't say I was entirely surprised.
Before it hit the papers, if I would ask, how are you usually given the news?
Well, people nominate, and if you're shortlisted, then they will ask you if you could kindly appear for an interview. So then you do, and you forget about it.
Then how have you prepared, if I should ask more about university, to probably counter the relationship between the students and the university, then of course the administration and the university in relation to the strikes that have been ongoing at the university, and also of course if it's not the students striking, then it is the administration or lecturers and all that?
Well, I should be quick to say that the day-to-day administration of the university is in the hands of the Vice Chancellor and the University Council and his deputies and the University Secretary. So I'm not involved in the day-to-day work of the university.
But you give advice, right?
When I'm asked to give advice, certainly I'm very happy to do so. And if I feel strongly about any aspect of the university, I'm again happy to express it.
Unless one typically belongs to the old school, modern life stories are never defined by one aspect of life. But Ezra Suruma's seven-decade journey belongs to the classroom. The renowned economist, computer scientist, and politician's life is a detailed book of academia whose beginnings traced in a desperate household in Rubanda West, Kabale District.
If you look back on your life as a child, you must have had dreams. What did those kind of dreams have? Did they point to banker, academician, economist, professor, or were they probably in a different direction?
I don't think I had such dreams. I don't think I knew what a bank or a banker was. I was forced to go to school. by my father. I had to go. I didn't have any choice. I walked long distances. It was extremely difficult and tiring. And it's a wonder that I managed to continue at all, because I would walk 5 miles to school, up and down hills, mm-hmm. and 5 miles back in the evening.
Born 11th November 1945 to Suruma Baliranwa and Esteri Baliranwa, Suruma is the seventh out of nine children. His story of a humble kid's book begins in the neck of the woods, trudging a 30-kilometer walk from home to Kikunjiri Primary School. He turned the second leaf of his book in academia at Chigezi High School, where he attained his own A level.
At what point in your life did you start to get the direction?
I had a direction in the sense that I wanted to succeed in school. I knew that I wanted to succeed and succeed as well as I could. And I was able to do that, I think, starting in probably P6 or thereabouts. I started to be serious and I started doing well. I had a cousin of mine who told me in order to be clever I needed to read books. And when he told me that, it helped me a great deal. Then I read all the books I could find. Mm-hmm. And then I find myself starting to lead classes. And it worked very well for me. And I wanted to continue that. And I continued. And I've never stopped.
So does it explain all this?
What do you often read about?
All this
and more. Everything. My field, other fields, philosophy, religion, mm-hmm. general knowledge.
What's that one thing throughout your childhood that probably many of the young generation are watching could learn from your journey of education?
Belief and trust in God is important to my life. It's a constant. And faith in God that things will be better. And that has helped me a great deal.
The font in his detailed book expanded further, accessing the blackboard overseas in Fordham University in New York City, where he attained a Bachelor of Science in Finance in 1969 and Master of Arts degree in Economics in 1972. The two awards in the USA completed only but just a chapter of his book.
You're a banker, an economist.
Yes.
An academician.
Yes.
Which of the three do you hold more significance to?
They are all related, of course. As an economist, academician, teaching in universities for 15 years before I became a director of research in the central bank, that gave me the background to understand perhaps quickly what was going on in the central bank and to play a leading role in restoring various aspects of the work at the Bank of Uganda. So from there I joined Uganda Commercial Bank, so I had an opportunity to learn commercial banking as well. Mm-hmm. So all these are related, and then I became Minister of Finance. So all that experience comes together to, I think, produce a good product. It's cumulative. It builds up and until hopefully one becomes excellent.
With the lights of New York still bright, however, the unfolding of his life was to be revealed by movements back home to which he had no hand but fate.
Well, I mean, the early years of my life were in academia as a student, as a lecturer and a professor, up until 1987, actually. So I was perhaps about 40 years old or thereabouts when I joined the central bank. Before that, in 1980, I had joined politics. We had formed the Uganda National Movement, which later joined with Yoweri Museveni to form the Uganda Patriotic Movement. So I had had a stint in politics even when I was in academia because things were not very good in Uganda. And it was difficult to sit on the sidelines and watch the situation continue to deteriorate. After spending that time, as I said, in academia, the National Resistance Movement, after taking power, asked me if I would come and work with them to restore the country. So I came in 1987 and left my work in the United States.